It's time to hear about an incredible story from training officer Brad Cusick, who took a week of vacation to go do some good in a country that truly needs a lot of Brad Cusicks.
I have been kind of trying to do this for a little while now, and I didn't really have the opportunity. The window kind of finally opened up, and it's kind of tough to do with a family, you know. But I went to Haiti for 8 days, Port-au-Prince most of the time, and then for a couple of days I was in the countryside in a town called Léogane and Fondoy, which is kind of in the mountain areas of Haiti, on a medical trip to basically work at a clinic, and I was there with Heart to Heart International.
This is the clinic. These are all the people we're going to see today.
I had an idea of what I was going into. I knew I was going to be working in a clinic setting, which is outside the box for what we do as paramedics. But when I got there, I think it was kind of a completely different experience. We almost functioned as physicians in a way. We would see patients.
This is where we work.
To assess, listen to what they had to tell us, what was going on with them, and basically just prescribe either treatment or medication. I kind of got a rough formulary of what medicines we had and what they were used for, another rough kind of protocol, common ailments, things that are prevalent down there right now, and again, what we prescribe or what treatments we do for them. And I just did that. We did have a Haitian doctor that was with us pretty much the whole time I was there, except for when I was in the countryside. I was by myself at that point. So if I had anything that was unusual or I didn't really know how to deal with it, I always had someone I could go to. I had never been to a third world country. I've never been to a disaster zone. And it's just it's a humbling experience in a way. You know, I think you very quickly realize what we have here and what we really take for granted very easily. It's a little overwhelming. I think when I first stepped off the plane, just the immediate differences were just noticeable. But as you know, as I was there, you know, in a week is a really ridiculously short amount of time to try to accomplish anything. But you know, it was just overwhelming in a lot of ways, just to see the devastation that's still there, the conditions that you know people are living in. You know. It's a little tough. One of the best things that Heart to Heart did for us when we were there is I had a designated interpreter, translator, the entire time I was there, and his name was Calix. He was a young man, 24 years old, speaks English, Creole, French, and Spanish fluently, super smart, very well educated, which isn't untypical of the population down there, honestly. And without his help, I wouldn't have been able to do what I did because he was with me with every patient, really every hour of the day that I was working. And even after I was working, too, he would hang out with us. So they do have an economy. A lot of street vendors. There are certainly shops. When I was there, it seemed like about every third building was rubble. And every other building was cracked or, you know, broken in some way. There weren't a lot of buildings that weren't untouched, to be honest with you. People are living in, you know, rubble piles and you know, big slabs of concrete are over, and people are living in the spaces between. So the conditions are pretty rough. Not the entire country is like that, though. I mean, Port-au-Prince was pretty much the epicenter, and they had most of the destruction. And that's also where most of the population happens to live as well. So it's crowded and it's broken. But yeah, there's things being sold, there's things being done. It's a slow process. I was talking to the locals down there about, or my counterparts down there about, is there ambulances? No, there's not any ambulances. The main hospital that was there, you know, collapsed during the initial quake. They do have a general hospital up and running now, but if, you know, someone's injured or hurt, if they go to the hospital, it's, you know, by foot or driven or by a taxi. There's no EMS to speak of. I didn't see any dengue when I was there. There is no vaccination for that. There's no vaccination for malaria either. I know I saw probably 100 cases of malaria while I was there. It's pretty prevalent. I mean, it's a tropical disease. It's a tropical country. A lot of mosquitoes. So prescribed a lot of medication for malaria, worms, a lot of worms medication. I was working in an environment where people were ill or injured and waiting all day, in many cases, 8 hours to see me, you know, to what I could do for them was limited. So I think my experience with the people in general was very limited. But what I did see was, people going about their lives. You know, they're working if they can. They're caring for their families if they can. They're trying to do what they can with what they can, which is pretty limited right now. But yeah, I saw a lot of happy people, a lot of concerned people about what's going to happen to their country and what they can do about it, and how powerless in a lot of ways they are to do anything, which was, sad. I would absolutely recommend it. It's an experience that if you have the opportunity to do something like that, I think it really can be, life-changing. If not, at least perspective-changing, which I think it was for me. It just gives you a different view on, what we have, and that's a good place to come from sometimes, a little shock to the system. If you do want to do something like that, I highly recommend it. Heart to Heart, of course, is always looking for people. They want to send medics there. They and EMTs as well. They like the idea that we work kind of autonomously. We have that built into us. We come from a place of working from protocols and working from formularies and finding a problem and dealing with it, and they really need people like that down there right now. They're a local organization as well. They're here in Olathe, so they're real easy to get a hold of. Their website has plenty of information about how to volunteer.
Well, thank you, Brad. Thank you for sharing that on FireComm. As I sat down and spoke with Brad about his trip, it became very clear to me that the passion that you see on the TV is multiplied when you're face-to-face with Brad. I would encourage you guys, as shifts, to perhaps invite him up for lunch. Get the opportunity to sit down around the table and hear some of the stories and hear the passion that Brad has for Haiti and the opportunities that may be there. And Brad, again, thank you so much.